So in this video, we will describe the ideas of enzymatic catalysis. We'll look at some rate data to understand how rates of enzyme-catalyzed reactions change. And then we'll try to make some connections between the structure of an enzyme substrate and the potential structure of an enzyme inhibitor. Enzymes are proteins. They're proteins that facilitate or catalyze the conversion of one molecule into another. The starting material is called a substrate, S. The product is called P. Enzymes, it's our E, bind a molecule of the substrate at the active site of the enzyme to make an enzyme-substrate complex in the middle of the screen. A reaction then occurs to form the product, which is immediately released from the enzyme. The enzyme can then find another substrate molecule and repeat the process. Drugs that act on enzymes are called inhibitors. Inhibitors bind to an enzyme and prevent the catalyzed transformation of a substrate into a product. On the screen is a graph that shows the rate of an enzyme's reaction against the concentration of an inhibitor, or the logarithm of the concentration of an added inhibitor. At very low inhibitor concentration, the rate of the reaction is high. It's about 100%. At high inhibitor concentration, on the right, the rate is low. It's about 0%. In between these extremes, the curve of rate versus log I follows a sigmoidal curve. The inflection point of this curve occurs at about 50% of the maximum rate. The x-axis value for this is log of IC50. The concentration at this point is IC50. The IC50 is the concentration of inhibitor required to reduce the rate by 50%. Determining the IC50 of an inhibitor requires multiple experiments to get data points that allow construction and interpretation of this curve. How do you design an inhibitor? Well, if you know the structure of the substrate, which binds an enzyme's active site, then maybe that structure of the substrate will tell us the structure of an inhibitor, which can also bind and block the active site of an enzyme. Let's see an example. Xanthine oxidase is an enzyme. Xanthine oxidase converts xanthine, the substrate, into uric acid, the product. To design an inhibitor for xanthine oxidase, we'd want a molecule that looks quite a bit like xanthine, so it'll bind to the active site. However, we don't want it to be too similar to xanthine because we don't want the inhibitor to undergo the reaction, so it has to be similar yet different. A known inhibitor of xanthine oxidase is allopurinol. Allopurinol resembles xanthine but lacks a carbon atom for the oxidation step of xanthine oxidase. Allopurinol is called a competitive inhibitor for xanthine oxidase. It's competitive because it is similar to xanthine and it competes for the active site with the substrate. So now we've seen enzymes, how enzymes catalyze reactions, and we can see how that catalysis is affected by inhibitors. And we also discussed how the structure of the substrate can tell us about the potential structure of inhibitors for that enzyme.